thinking about it, I mean, in the present milieu, in the present system, what would Gandhi have done? One is, as far as the governance is concerned, I think the independence that immediately after independence, it is very unfortunate that Gandhi died and he did not have a role in designing the governance systems of a country immediately after independence. So the kind of system that we created for ourselves is not the kind of system that Gandhi wanted. Gandhi wanted Swaraj. Gandhi wanted governance by the people. But what we today have is not Swaraj. It is governance by politicians and bureaucrats. For instance, concretely, the kind of democracy we have today is we go out and vote once in 5 years and we say that we have elected the new government or we have elected the new king, the modern king. And next 5 years, we have absolutely no say in governance. We keep on pleading and pleading and pleading before the people who we voted in power or the bureaucrats. In ancient India, this was not the system. In Buddha's time, Vaishali was the first republic of the world. That was the first democracy of the world, wherein the son of the king became a king. So the people did not vote the king in power, but most of the places, the king did not have the power to rule. The decisions were taken in village assemblies. The people gathered and the people's assemblies took decisions and those decisions were binding on the king. And there are several instances from Siddhartha Gautam's life where meeting is going on, a proposal is put up, Siddhartha Gautam is against the proposal, the king is against the proposal, but the people say that we want this and the proposal is carried and the king has to implement it. That was democracy. And that kind of system continued till 1830, wherein the village assemblies ruled India. Village assemblies ruled their own villages. They took all the decisions with respect to their own villages. All the Mughal invaders who came controlled only the central government. They did not interfere with the village assemblies. In 1830, for the first time, the then acting Governor General, Lord Metcalfe, writes that the foundation of this country is the village assemblies, the villages and the country being ruled by village assemblies. And the British realized that if they have to conquer India, they have to demolish the system and they introduced collector Raj. All the powers were taken away from village assemblies and they were given to a British collector. And earlier, irrigation used to be handled by the people, education used to be handled by the people, the various other aspects of life were handled by the people. Now for each such item, departments were created. You had irrigation department, you had education department, all these departments were, the head of the thing was collector, and collector was a British guy. Unfortunately, after independence, we continued with the same system of governance. We did not restore this power back to the people. And we continued with the same system. So we replaced British collector with an Indian collector. This is not what Gandhi's dream was. Gandhi's dream was that there are 7 lakh villages and he wanted that each village should be a republic unto itself. These are the words used by him. That means everything that can be done in a village should be done in that village. What cannot be done in a village should go to the next tier of governance. What cannot be done at this tier of governance should go to next. So ideally at the central level, they should deal only with currency, foreign affairs, security of the country, 3 or 4 items, that's it. But today the kind of system that we have is the central government is trying to rule the entire country. They have given some subjects to the state government and no powers to the people of this country. This is not Swaraj. So we want Swaraj. Gandhi would have fought for Swaraj. He would have fought for a governance system where people take decisions. And all the fissiparous divisive tendencies which are there in this country, Northeast is asking for a separate country. Naxalites are so active in so many parts of the country. All this is there because people find that they have no voice in the present system of governance. And the moment we have a system of governance where people will be able to rule themselves, I think none of these divisive tendencies would be able to find any fertile soil anywhere and they would have to go. I think it is basically these two things are interrelated, that when you have a governance system which actually encourages people's entrepreneurial skills, creative skills to be able to express positively, I think that that creates a positive kind of an environment that creates positive energy in the entire society and that also helps in personal spiritual growth. But today the kind of system that we have is it's stunting everyone's creative growth, it's stunting everyone's entrepreneurial skills. If anyone wants to do anything, the society and the government are always there to kill your creativity rather than encourage that.